welcome to this massive open online course titled Principles of Communication Systems, and this is part 1 of the course. I am Aditya Jagannatham, a faculty member in the Electrical Engineering Department at IIT Kanpur. So, as the name implies, this course is concerned with the fundamental principles of communication systems, the basic or the key principles that are necessary to understand the functioning of communication systems, several communication systems, starting from the most basic ones such as based on amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, to the most modern ones such as based on digital communication and cellular systems, all right. So, as I was saying, it is a very fundamental course. It's an undergraduate undergraduate level course, but also can lay the groundwork for some concepts in graduate level courses such as wireless communications and more modern communication systems, all right. So, we are going to cover the various fundamental concepts of communication systems, which are essential, which can lay the groundwork or lay the foundation to understand the more advanced concepts of communication systems, such as when we look at cellular communication systems or Wi-Fi or cooperative communication systems, etc. So, let us look at some of these concepts. So, one of the key concepts that we are going to start with is basically amplitude modulation. It is one of the most fundamental and oldest techniques of analog communication. Amplitude modulation is one of the earliest techniques of radio wave communication, in which a message signal modulates the amplitude of a high frequency carrier wave. Okay? And in amplitude modulation, there are several issues. For instance, how is amplitude modulation performed? What are the various factors that affect amplitude modulation? What are the various demodulation and modulation strategies? Right? What are the various techniques of amplitude modulation, such as single sideband modulation, double sideband modulation, vestigial sideband modulation? These are the techniques that we are going to look at, and we are going to understand amplitude modulation in a very fundamental way, since carrier modulation is also employed in all the major communication systems, such as when you look at cellular communication systems or other communication systems, even in the modern wireless communication systems. All right? Now, frequency modulation. That is another interesting and one of the very fundamental and again one of the oldest communication systems employing radio wave signals, all right. So, in which the frequency of a high frequency carrier wave is varied in proportion to a modulating signal, right. Now, we would like to understand how is frequency modulation carried out, why is the performance of frequency modulation robust, right. How do we generate frequency modulation system, what are the principles governing the generation of frequency modulation system, frequency modulated signals, and the demodulation of frequency modulated signals, what are the various parameters. All right. Now, following this, we will make a transition to digital communication systems. That is, we have analog information signals, analog message signals such as voice, that is your speech signal, video signal, and several other signals. Now, how do you convert them into a digital format or a digital information symbol so as to make them suitable for transmission over the modern digital communication system or wireless digital communication system such as cellular, Wi-Fi, etc. So, how do you process the information, right? Now, how do you sample? Naturally, one has to sample these signals. So, what are the properties of this sampling operation, right? What are the distortions that are introduced by the sampling in sampling operation? How do you ensure that the information, the original analog information, can be reconstructed accurately from the sampled signal or from the digital information that is generated from the sampled signal. So, these are the aspects, these are the fundamental principles which govern all the communication systems and which are necessary for understanding even advanced wireless advanced communication systems that we are going to look at in this course, all right. So, this course, I would like to again sum up saying it looks at the fundamental principles of communications which are necessary to understand, right. These will be explained in a very clear and lucid fashion so that it bridges the gap between the theory, the theoretical concepts that students are aware of, and the application of these, and it is supposed to lay the foundation, all right, to a solid foundation to understand and motivate an understanding of advanced communication or the more modern wireless communication systems such as cellular, 2G, 3G, 4G, and now even 5G wireless communication systems, Wi-Fi, and several other communication systems such as cooperative communication systems or cognitive radio communication systems, etc. Okay? And this course is intended for primarily anyone who is interested in learning more about the principles of communication, engineering students, science students, management students, and students at the undergraduate and also the postgraduate level students who are looking looking to enhance their understanding of the fundamental principles of communication systems, you can take this course, and also the part 2 of this course, which is expected to come later, which is expected to focus on the performance of communication systems in noise, and also more importantly digital communication systems, information theoretic aspects, and probably some coding aspects, etc. All right. And since this is a fundamental course, the prerequisites are fairly basic. It requires a knowledge, a basic knowledge of mathematics, differentiation, rules of differentiation, integration, a basic theory of signals and systems such as the Fourier transform, discrete Fourier series, and also some familiarity with high level concepts such as modulation, noise, etc. will additionally be beneficial, although strictly speaking this is not necessary. All right. So, once again I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to this fundamental course on communication systems. All right. I hope you will benefit and you will learn a lot from this course, and the principles and the concepts that you learn from this course will motivate you and will also help you understand the properties, the behavior, and analyzing the performance of communications or more advanced communication systems that you will encounter in the future or in a graduate level course. Thank you very much.